Suppose you plan on giving 7 gold stars to some of the 13 high-achieving students in your class. Each student can receive at most 1 star. How many ways can you do this? The method of stars and bars is not needed here, even though I will show how to use the stars and bars method in just a moment. Because each student can receive at most 1 star, we can more easily answer this question by determining 13 choose 7. 13 choose 7 will give the number of groups of 7 we can form from the 13 students, where those 7 students would be the ones receiving the gold stars. And 13 choose 7 is equal to 1,716, giving 1,716 ways to give out the 7 gold stars to 13 students, given each student can receive at most 1 star. Now, if we do want to use the method of stars and bars, we also have to use the principle of inclusion exclusion. Let's also show that method. So to begin, because there are 7 indistinguishable stars, we have 7 stars, and because there are 13 distinguishable students, there are 12 bars. So if there were no restrictions on giving out the 7 gold stars, they could be given out in 19 choose 12 ways. Remember, it's always the sum of the stars and bars choose the number of bars. But again, this is with no restrictions, meaning some students could get more than 1 star. So if we want to use the stars and bars method to answer the question, we now have to use the principle of inclusion exclusion to eliminate all distributions in which one or more students get more than 1 star. So we'll begin by subtracting the number of ways to give out the 7 gold stars when we start by giving 1 student 2 stars, which can be done in 13 choose 1 times 17 choose 12 ways. 13 choose 1 is the number of ways of choosing one of the 13 students to receive the 2 stars, which leaves only 5 stars to give out to the 13 students with no restrictions, which can be done in 17 choose 12 ways. But this subtracts too much, and therefore now we have to add back in the number of ways of giving out the 7 gold stars when we assign 2 students to get 2 stars to begin, and then distribute the remaining stars, which gives us plus 13 choose 2 times 15 choose 12. 13 choose 2 is the number of ways to choose the 2 students from the 13 where each received 2 stars. Once they both receive 2 stars, there's only 3 stars remaining, because 7 minus 4 is 3, to distribute among the 13 students. And that can be done in 15 choose 12 ways, again with no restrictions. But this adds too much back in, so now we have to subtract the number of ways of giving out 7 gold stars to 13 students when 3 students begin with 2 stars, leaving 1 star to distribute among the 13 students. And this can be done in 13 choose 3 times 13 choose 12 ways. 13 choose 3 is the number of ways of selecting the 3 students in which each will receive 2 stars. And 13 choose 12 is the number of ways of distributing the remaining star to the 13 students. And we can stop here because there's no way 4 students can receive 2 stars, because 4 times 2 is 8, and there's only 7 stars to begin with. This leaves us with 19 choose 12 minus the product of 13 choose 1 and 17 choose 12, plus the product of 13 choose 2 and 15 choose 12, minus the product of 13 choose 3 and 13 choose 12, which is the same result of 1,716 ways. I hope you found this helpful.